after cryptocurrency prices have fallen, you know, over 50% in the last few months or so, some people are sitting around wondering, like, hey, how can I even make money right now inside of crypto? You know, my portfolio is completely wrecked, and who knows when these prices are going to recover again to their all-time highs. Well, in this video, I'm going to talk about the best way to make money with crypto today and how you can actually get started on this today. So before we get into that, if you're new around here, hey, I'm Gregory, and on this channel, I turn you into a blockchain master. So if that's something that you're interested in, then smash that like button down below for the YouTube algorithm and subscribe to this channel. And if you want to learn how to become a blockchain master step-by-step start to finish, then head on over to dappuniversity.com/bootcamp to get started today. All right, so let's get into this. So one of the reasons I'm making this video is because I see so many people looking to crypto to secure their financial future. They're basically just betting that this is going to take off over time. And so they're looking at this as their only hope. And I see some people kind of discouraged because they think, hey, in order to make, you know, life-changing amount of money with cryptocurrency, then I have to have, you know, a ton of money to put into this in the first place. And I actually saw this post come up on Reddit here. It says, young people may not have as much capital invest, but you're rich in time. And he's saying, you know, if you're young and just starting out, it can suck to see whales making millions overnight during a measly 5% pump or whatever, because they already have millions in capital, while your small initial investment will still not earn you very much, even if your coin goes 10x. But I would say you're in a much better position because you have time on your side, which is just as valuable of an asset. And he's saying basically 10 years in crypto is worth more than 10 million in his opinion. And now he makes a lot of really good points in this post, but I want to provide some counter arguments that'll show you how what a better way is actually to make money with crypto than just like put all your money in here and wait forever and really hope that it pays off. So first off, I think he's right. You know, even if you put a small amount of capital in and your coin goes 10x, then that may not be a huge amount of return. Let's say you only had $1,000 to invest and it went up 10x, then you had $10,000, which is awesome. But for most people in the grand scheme of things, like $10,000 is not necessarily going to be a life-changing amount of money. Now, for some people, it definitely will. But I mean, what if you just had $10,000 right now to invest and then that went up 10x, then that would be $100,000. Or if you had $100,000 to invest, that would go up 10x and then that goes to $1 million. So now we're starting to get more into life-changing money territory for a larger number of people. And so what he's saying here is right, is if you don't have sort of the minimum amount of money to invest into something like this, then you're probably not going to see the same benefit as other people. Now that's the bad news, but here's the good news. And this is where I would differ him on this. So instead of just like taking a small amount of money and putting in there and waiting forever and hoping that it actually turns into life-changing money, you can actually make life-changing money with your time. And that's what he's talking about. He's trying to use time over the long term, but you can use your time right now, like today, to make money inside of crypto. So how do you do that? Well, it's by investing in yourself and your own skills. And this is a rule of thumb that I see applying everywhere, whether you're trying to invest in your real estate, stocks, crypto, whatever it is. If you don't have the minimum amount of money to really get into the game to make a significant return, let's just say the number is like five figures, for example. And let's say you only have maybe like $1,000 to invest, then you're probably going to get a much more significant return on that actual investment by putting it into yourself and increasing your skills so that you can make more money and then actually turn around and invest that money. Because if you could invest $1,000 into something that gives you cash flow where you now have $1,000 extra per month to invest, and then you can take those gains and then put them into something that's actually going to increase in value over time, whether it's crypto or traditional investments, then that's going to be a way better investment for that small amount of money. And if you're young, like he's saying here in this post, then you have an additional component, which is time. So time to actually learn these skills and then money to actually invest acquiring the knowledge and information to get these skills. Now, the good news is if you're super interested in crypto and you're technically savvy, then you don't have to like go back to college and get some fancy degree in order to do this. That's one of the reasons I'm so huge on blockchain development, actually learning the technical skills required to build this technology, because you don't have to have a fancy computer science degree in order to do it. It's one of the highest paying fields in tech. It's super in demand. You can basically learn these skills in a relatively short amount of time on the grand scheme of things and actually change your career and get a really highly paid skill like this to have extra money to invest if you don't have, you know, a ton of money sitting around right now to try to make returns in the crypto markets. And honestly, I think it's one of the better moves for a lot of people because crypto is so volatile and people are basically looking at this to be their long-term solution to fix their financial problems. But for most people, fixing that cash flow problem is going to be better for them in the first place. It's going to be more sustainable and give you that quality of life that I think a lot of people are looking for. And the barrier of entry is pretty low on the grand scheme of things. And that's one of the reasons I talk about it so much on this YouTube channel, create this free educational content around this, and so that you all can actually get your hands dirty and learn these insanely valuable skills to take advantage of this opportunity, because this is the biggest opportunity in crypto for most people right now. Sure, you know, buying cryptocurrency and holding on to it for the long term is a really great thing to do as well. I mean, I personally do it, but actually doubling down and learning a technical skill that can provide you returns for life is the best way to actually make money with this over the long term. And one of the reasons I think this, honestly, is because when you're putting money in your crypto, there's so much that's outside of your control. So I want to bring up another post and kind of talk about this. So he says, basically, I'm holding onto my crypto because I can't see any better options for millennials, even though, you know, the caveat here is even though the prices have gone down, he's saying savings accounts, well, hey, they only earn 0.1% interest. Real estate, you know, basically, their prices are so expensive, millennials can barely afford to own a property. Higher education degree, you know, costs so much and doesn't necessarily give you all these extra advantages, and that the opportunities aren't really quite there like they were in stocks 10 years ago. So there's a lot of truth to this, and I do think that crypto is a good option to hold some value and actually get those kind of investment gains long term compared to these some of the other options. But going back to what I was saying a minute ago, for a lot of people who don't have a ton of money to put into crypto to make these life-changing gains, which honestly, it kind of does take a little bit of extra money to do that, the better bet's going to be to reinvest back into yourself. But even beyond that, when you're putting money into crypto, like, everything's pretty much out of your control. If you actually make money with it over the long term, you don't really have any influence over that. You're just hoping that the market, like, works out in your favor. So, you know, if you're buying crypto and you buy at the top of the market and it goes down and it takes years to recover, you don't have any influence over that. Or if you bought a coin that somehow, you know, has a major problem with it and it goes to zero and never recovers, you don't have any influence over that either. And so that's why I'm so big on skills on this channel and actually teaching you hard technical skills as the best way to make long-term wealth with crypto, is because you have way more control over that, all right? Of course, you don't have ultimate control of your own destiny. So many bad things could happen to you, but you have way more influence over how you spend your time than you do on just what's happening with the overall markets. Because if you actually implement a plan to put into action on how you can master these skills up to a point where you can break into this industry and somebody can take a chance on you and actually hire you and start earning that pay and work your way up in your career, you can do that way faster and you have way more control over that than just hoping that crypto works out. And now let me make two points on why this is really important to do, like, now, like today. Well, number one, the really great thing about the blockchain industry is that so much capital has flooded into this space despite the fact that cryptocurrency prices have gone down. We just saw a massive infusion of capital, over $2.2 billion from A16Z to invest in crypto companies. We're seeing lots of other people invest money into this space to build long-term applications, infrastructure, DeFi, et cetera, et cetera. And they all need, you know, blockchain developers to help realize this vision. That's one of the reasons the demand is so high and the supply is relatively small in the grand scheme of things, and that's what makes the skill itself so lucrative. So that's what's great about right now, is that all this money's flowing into the space. A lot of them have cashed out of crypto and can reinvest that back into these long-term opportunities like building companies. And they all want to hire blockchain developers despite the fact that cryptocurrency prices have gone down. That's what's key, because they know the long-term potential is technology and they want to get in and get ahead while the space is quiet. And that's point number two, is you kind of have to think about this counterintuitively. Like, when the space kind of gets quiet like this, that can be one of the absolute best times to, like, double down and get ahead in crypto, because you get in really strong position for the next wave that comes out. So let's say that you were, you know, doubling down, learning your blockchain skills while the space is a little bit quieter than it was, you know, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 months ago. Well, if you acquire those skills now and you can actually get to the point where you can earn money, then you might be in a really strong position whenever that next wave comes back. And so that's why I think right now is also a pretty unique time to actually be breaking into this field. And honestly, it's night and day difference from when I started off, because I started off in 2017, you know, when the bubble popped, and then I worked all throughout that entire bear market, you know, building up this channel, getting all this experience with blockchain, building applications, and that helped me really get in a strong position to, you know, take advantage of this big opportunity while the space is absolutely exploding like it has been in the past several months. So everything that I'm telling you about and why it's a good idea is I have done it personally myself. And I've helped lots of other people do it. Like I said, I've helped people, you know, with zero coding experience break into real world blockchain development in a matter of months. And a lot of them were, you know, focused on this space while it was quiet, and they were able to really capitalize on that opportunity as soon as it exploded. And so if you've stuck around and, like, you're even watching this video, first and foremost, congratulations, number one. So many people have left this space, you know, since it's gotten quieter, since the prices have, you know, gone down, and they just, you know, all the fair weather people in crypto are pretty much gone at this point. So if you're watching this video right now at about the time of recording this video, then that's not you. So step one, congratulations. questions. And step two, like if you want to jump into this, like what's the best way to get started? Well, like anything else, the best way to learn is to learn by doing. And that's one of the primary methodologies that I teach on this channel. That's why I have these step-by-step coding tutorials, you know, on my YouTube homepage. You can go there for like Udemy courses, but they're totally free. You can actually learn to build projects and learn the programming languages as you go. I'm huge on project-based learning. It's better than trying to learn individual programming languages first and then go actually build a project second, because it's more efficient. It gets you excited about what you're learning. It gives you context. You know, what's the best way to learn a foreign language? Well, through immersion. It's the same type of thing with coding. How do you learn a programming language? You learn by getting immersed into a project and then, you know, acquiring the skills that way. And that's exactly how I teach you on this channel. So go check out one of those if you think that blockchain development might be something that you're interested in. If you're already a developer already, you're gonna breeze through these applications. But if you're brand new, these are a great way to like get your hands dirty and jump on this opportunity while the space is quiet. So that's all I got for today. As always, smash that like button down below for the YouTube algorithm. Subscribe to this channel if you haven't already. That really helps these videos out so more people can learn about blockchain. Again, like I said, if you want to get started learning this stuff today, just go to my YouTube homepage, find those free courses there. But if you want to take the next step, or hey, maybe you want to take a massive shortcut entirely, you know, you should become a blockchain master step-by-step start to finish over at dappuniversity.com/bootcamp. You don't have to be an expert to get started today. I've helped people with zero coding experience become real-world blockchain developers in a matter of months. So that's all I've got. Until next time, thanks for watching Dapp University.